Thank you for staying with us. The Senate President, Hamed Lawan, has expressed disappointment over the sorry state of the temporary isolation center for victims of coronavirus, COVID-19, in Abuja. He also stated that the 620 million naira earmarked for Nigeria Center for Disease Control, the NCDC, no money has been released for the center. This is contrary to the statement by the Minister of Health, Dr. Osagie Ehanire, saying that all funds have been released to the center. Now, who should we believe? Joining me still to discuss this is political analyst Mukhtar Mohammed and also Sam Adeleke. Thank you, gentlemen, for staying with us. Now, the Senate President has stated that no kobo has been released for the isolation center in Abuja. But just before I take a reaction, we do have a video of him making that statement. Let's take a look.
Inspection here, the temporary isolation center is really not in good shape. It's not, it doesn't look ready to receive any patient. And I believe that this is something that we have to fix between today and tomorrow. We are in an emergency. Even if we don't have people who are affected, we shouldn't just rest on our oars. We have to do everything and anything possible to fix that temporary isolation center to be prepared and ready to receive anyone who falls sick in this respect. I am sad, we're indeed sad that of the 620 million naira that was supposed to be released to this place for fixing of everything here,
NCDC,
not a kobo has been released. We are going to get to across to the Minister of Finance and all the other authorities who have anything to do with this to release this money between today and tomorrow. By the end of tomorrow, that temporary site must be ready. No generator, no electricity if PHCN goes off. In fact, nothing. We went in, nothing. There were two or three air conditioners that were brought this morning. Maybe because yesterday we said we were coming here. This is not acceptable. We as leaders and people giving responsibility, we have to do what is right. So if we are not coming here, maybe this place wouldn't have anything. This is unfortunate. So Ministry of Finance released the 620 million.
Contradicting statement, the Minister of Health, Osagie Ehanire, and now the Senate President, Hamed Lawan. How do we begin to reconcile these two statements? Him saying no funds have been released, and Dr. Ehanire did say funds have been released. Is there some kind of foul play, monkey business going on in this already? Mukhtar.
It's not surprising. That's been the term of the Buhari administration. It has been infighting. It's the National Security Advisor not fighting the chief of staff. The chief of staff is not fighting. There's contradicted, remember that even Buhari himself gave an order to the IG to be in Benue State. The IG was not in Benue State. So these are not new to us. We've seen the ministers of both. We remember that there was a fight between the Minister for Labor and Productivity, Ngige, and also the current chairman of APC, Adam Oshomole. So they've been infighting, not surprising. The government has not been in cohesion at all. So I'm not surprised at what is happening now. The only challenge you have is that I expected them to see this as a national issue because lives are being involved in it. But not to forget that the National Assembly has forgotten that money approved is always not money released. So there's a processes whereby money will be released. Yes. You can't just say within 48 hours. But in terms of national issues, like that, I expected the Ministry of Finance to have moved faster than this within 24 hours, even if you are not releasing all basic necessity. Even if you look at even when we had the coronavirus, when the issue was even made mention, our airport, people came in, there was nothing, absolutely nothing, until we had somebody test positive of coronavirus. That's when we begin to equip the airport. We now started having doctors, we now started giving people phone. Even the center, remember that it took them the victim that was quarantined to shout before the governor Lagos State had to visit that the center should be kept well and should be rehabilitated within 24 hours. So we are a country that is never prepared for disaster. We are a country that never looked at disaster as any issue. We are a country that instead of doing what we ought to do, we'll go to the church or we'll go to the mosque to pray. That is what we are.
Now, Sam, I need your reaction on this, man.
Okay, well, for me, it's quite interesting to see the passion with which the Senate president was talking, because this is a government in power. You have the access straight, number one, to the president. You have access to the Minister of Health. Why are you now genuflecting and giving us reality TV show and giving us speeches when you can as well make calls? I'm sure you guys are in one WhatsApp group, you know, so don't do this to us. Don't make us look like we are going to empathize with you. Because number one, your job as executive, and of course, that's to provide this, and then legislative to carry oversight functions. Now, what he has said about the thing getting ready in 24 hours is just blowing hot smoke. You can't do anything about it. If the Federal Ministry of Health does not do anything about it, if that money has actually not been released, if there is no cash, liquid cash to spend, nothing will happen. You know, so the good part is, this is meant to be for the benefit of Nigerians. As of today, there is no black man in sub-Saharan Africa that has the COVID-19 virus. That's why probably the pace of execution and of putting up facilities is very slow, because they're like, okay, nothing. That is a white man virus. It's that we are immune. That apathy, you know, and that lackadaisical attitude is what the Senate president is addressing here, which I think is a good
thing. Now, you did say, in sub-Saharan Africa, no person has been confirmed.
No black man. African. Yes.
I mean, and with many people have taken to the opinion that there's really no outbreak of coronavirus in Nigeria.
I tell you, man, because yes, people are saying that is audio virus, because it is after they approved that money. That was when we discovered the index case. They're like, okay, that means money has to be spent. So people are even saying that these 620 million have actually been shared already, and that they know that thing will not pass that one person and to not spread. So
do you have a contrary view to that?
Well, I think the 620 million was actually approved immediately they had this issue. I think it was 320.
Exactly, it was 320. 320,
so I didn't know when it got to 620. In short, I'm hearing 620 for them, because what I knew was 320. That was approved for issue of this coronavirus. So, like I said, I still believe that the government is not prepared for this.
Now, it's about a week now, or over a week now, since the first outbreak of COVID-19 was discovered in Nigeria and Lagos State, to be very particular. And as it stands now, the isolation center is still unprepared. Does this make our government in any way look pretty irresponsible?
Of course, but remember that maybe the isolation center is now better, because even the corona victim that was quarantined saying that, oh, it's better now, they've been able to give him easier. And they are doing some tracing to bring in some people in there. I think it just shows, it shows leadership. It shows that the leader determines what happens. Because if you remember that we have had issues like this, leadership sometimes can come from the top, but sometimes can come from the bottom. The time we have the Ebola issue, the leadership came from the bottom, and the top was able to complement it. I then remember the then Commissioner for Health of Lagos State, GD Idris. He was on top of it. The current Commissioner for Health in Lagos State, it took him a long time before to even respond to things like this, knowing that Lagos State is the economic capital of Nigeria. And you know that we have a lot of infrastructural problems going on here in Nigeria, especially in Lagos. We should have taken preventive measures. We didn't have to wait for somebody to come in and be test positive for coronavirus before we have an isolation center. What happened to the former center that we had during the Ebola crisis? After it, did we just throw it away? Did we not even do something about it? We will now have set itself as an emergency isolating center for issues like this.
Now, Sam, let's look at the figure involved here. 620 million naira for an isolation center. Would you think, in hindsight, with the epidemic that coronaviruses, would you consider that amount too small or too high for an isolation center?
I think we should look or ask for more details of how this is to be expended. To be honest, it is not too big.
Okay.
Because other parts of the world The World Bank is committing about $12 billion. Dangote is saying he's committing 200 million naira. You know, so people are deploying cash. Now, the bulk of that cash should actually be deployed towards fighting misinformation and towards educating the people, because fear is even it's a bigger factor in killing people than even the virus itself. If we look at the bombing incident that happened in Lagos, then that's the cantonment bomb.
Yeah.
You know, that happened many years ago. It was even the fear of the noise that's far away that drew people into the canal.
Exactly,
Ikeja cantonment. So it was not even the issue itself. So right now, bulk of that money, of course, we can't spend up to 2, 3, 4, 5 million equipping that place, if we are to be sure, if we are to be honest. Mm-hmm. But then bulk of that money should be spent towards research, towards equipping that hospital. Because let me give you an example of the infectious disease center in Lagos where the man is quarantined. During the punch investigation, the reporter asked one of the workers there that, madam, why are you not even wearing mask? You know, and he said, mask again, what's this coronavirus? We've been here for many years, living with people with infectious diseases, and we've not died. You get, so it's not even so much about the people there, but also equipping such places and ensuring that our health system is good. So we should be looking beyond coronavirus,
okay,
but also ensuring that all our facilities across the country, you know, healthcare is a basic right of Nigerians. So right, this should be used in building and developing hospitals across
the
board.
Okay, now, Mokhtar, the novel case of the coronavirus still remains this Italian man who, up to today, is faceless and nameless to Nigerians. Now, many people have argued the fact that this could have just been some fabrications to achieve something. How do you react to this?
No, I don't think so. Okay. You remember, in medical time is always private. And that's why when issues happen, they will say they will talk to the family. I don't think it's high time, because the organization that brought the man to Nigeria, that's Lafarge WAFCO, have admitted that he was brought in by them from Italy and even visited the Lafarge WAFCO plant. And so they're even doing tracing there. I don't think it has anything to do that. Maybe because money was released, now we now have an index, one quiz. I think basically it's really true that we had a victim that is a coronavirus victim. Whether we need to begin to see him and begin to talk to him, I don't think that is necessary at the moment, because also he has his privacy. He's supposed to be health issues are always private matters.
All right, thank you very much. Mokhtar Mohammed, political analyst, thank you for being on Plus Politics and for your contribution. And also Sam Adeleke, thank you very much for being with us this evening.
Thank you.
And thank you for staying with us. We'll take our Plus reports now, and when we return, I'll be giving you my take. Do stay with us.
There was a heated debate on the floor of the Senate as lawmakers were divided over the bill seeking to establish Southwest Development Commission. The bill, which was proposed by Senator Ebukunle Amosun from Ogun State, is seeking to galvanize the Southwest, tackle infrastructural deficit, and re-establish the region as a major agricultural hub. However, some lawmakers think the bill is unnecessary and insist it seeks to disintegrate the country.
Today, with an ever-increasing population, due to rural-urban migration, facilities in the Southwest region, especially social amenities, are increasingly stretched, just as living standards continue to plummet. Majority of roads are calling for urgent attention. Many state-owned hospitals have inadequate medical personnel and equipment that can properly manage the health needs of patients. Educational institutions are not what they used to be. Industrial estates have become desolate, while a few, which are still functional, are struggling to remain in business.
This commission will unlock the resources and the potentials of the Southwest. The Southwest has been frontrunner in terms of development in the past. The first industrial estates in Ikeja and in Lupeju, the first television in Africa, the first Liberty Stadium in Africa, the rubber plantation, all these were in the Southwest. But as the sponsor of this bill said, there has been a sort of deterioration. And I think this commission will revitalize and re-engineer the energy of the region.
Not be the chamber where basis for disintegrating Nigeria should be discussed. Mr. President, there was first Ometeku. Now there is Southwest Development Commission. Now all the other commissions that were approved by this Senate, NDDC, Northeast, were actually children of circumstances. Northeast was devastated by Boko Haram and all the wars, and they need rehabilitation. The same thing with Niger Delta. Because of the oil exploration activities, the livelihood of the people there was almost rendered useless, and they could not farm, they could not fish, but they need all these activities. So the Niger Delta Commission was created. I cannot see a reason why Southwest Commission should be Development Commission should be created.
It's very important to say that this bill is not about anybody seeking to disengage Nigeria. And I take that point from the submission of distinguished elder as a Tobukashwa. We need to make that point clear. If any region had made sacrifice for unity and development of this country, it is the Southwest region. We need to make it clear for posterity. And Amoteku is a different thing entirely from Southwest development. What distinguished deputy minority leader has said, we are talking about development here. I think that the issue we should be talking is that there may be possibility of proliferation of Western Development Commission. If that is the issue, it has been answered by other senators here, that some other senators are interested in bringing Development Commission for different regions. That should not stop it.
What we are doing today, Mr. President, in this Senate, we passed two bills, the Northeast Development Bill and the Southeast Development Bill. The president, in his wisdom, because he loved the unity of this country, did not sign one because he does not want balkanization. What we are doing today, indirectly, is if you decide, like my distinguished senator Lero has said, I agree with him. If you say we will pass this, then every zone will have its own commission, including Midwest. We will bring the Midwest Development Commission for the people, for Edo and Delta.
Mr. President, I was here when my respected elder statesman informed me that their own two from North Central is coming.
Yes.
North Central. Elder statesman, I'm talking of Abdullah Adamu, Senator Adamu. And Jibril Barau is also bringing his son from Northwest. So why are we getting agitated for nothing? The, in fact, refusal to pass this bill will rather divide us the more.
Here is my take. The leadership crisis in the ruling All Progressives Congress is one that has the capacity to cause the destruction of lives and properties in the country, as it was exemplified in Edo State recently. And why? Because some leaders want to hold on to power by all means possible. Their leaders, it's time to put your followers first and put aside every one of your political differences. If the members of the ruling party do not want Oshomele, then he should step down with the little honor he has left and avoid further disgrace. And as for the isolation center, I have to say that it is sad that in our democracy, anything goes as long as the power to do so is available. Why would one part of the government say money has been released and the other part says that it has not? Where is the money then? And who is responsible for the implementation of what the money is for? I believe our leaders are simply playing games because coronavirus hasn't ravaged the country just as yet. Nigeria is a blessed country, but let us not test the limits of the blessing. Let us do what needs to be done and let us do it right and now. May the odds ever be in our favor. And that's our show for tonight. Join us again tomorrow, same time. Do you have a great evening.